we are going to learn how to create AI app, AI Android app, right? So I'm going to show you this app, right? So we are going to create this app. So I'm going to show you how it's look. That one is our front page of app, right? So I'm just typing here first name, S-O-U-R-A-B-H, like this. Okay, just click on go and you will see.
Hello Sorb, how may I help you?
Right, now we are going to ask to Ellie, like, what is the capital of India? Yeah, what is the capital of US, right? So just click on this button first. What is the capital of India?
The capital of India is New Delhi.
Right, we can ask many questions because we have done a lot of code in this Android app, right? So let me show you how to create this Android app using MIT App Inventor, right? Okay,
so let's start. Open MIT App Inventor 2 here, let's say, and open MIT App Inventor 2 dashboard, and here you will see start your project. Just click on this button and type your app name, like AI Ali, my app name. You can give any name, right? So just that one is our screen, first screen, right? So here we are going to use layout first. So just click on layout option and we are going to use here vertical arrangement. So drag and drop to vertical arrangement, right? And here height is fill parent and width is also fill parent, like this. Second one also fill parent, and that one is fill parent, right? So now we are going to use a button, right? So first we need to use one button, one text box for getting input from username, right? For username, right? And using here one label for label, right? So here just change the label, like welcome, right? And here font size something 30, and background color, we need to change vertical alignment background color. Default color is black, so we are going to use here some cell color, like this, right? Okay, then that one is our color, right? So now we are going to change the button. So we are going to use here like star, like this, and that one is our first screen, right? So we are going to change or hide the second visible, second screen. So we just check here visible, and that one is our first screen, right? So we need to arrange this screen, right? Like width is like full parent, right? And text is like width is, and then it's also fill parent, right? And alignment center, like this. You can change the text color, right? So I'm going to use something like orange, or I just want to change the background color, like some dark color. So that will be see like this one, right? So change, you can change the button background color also, right? So like orange, like this, right? So let's go to the code, right? And here you can change this text alignment center is like you need two visuals, like the parent, like this, right? That's one good. So we are going to block option. Whenever someone is click on our button, type some name, and whenever you click on button one, so our vertical arrangement one is visible is hide, like here that one, which has been false, and copy paste this one, and vertical arrangement two will show the user like two, like this. So now we are going to use here the speech recognition, like here we're going to use text to speech or speech recognition, right? So we are going to use two things. So that one is speech recognition first, and second is text to speech. That one is convert our text to speech. Like here I'm going to type here some name like Harry or Ellie. So Ellie will give hello Saurav, or hello Ellie, like this, right? So we need to write here some code to do this. So we need to just text to speech, call to text to speech whenever we click on button 1. So call text to speech. Here we are going to use text joiner, like, and default text like hello or hi, like here, hello. Or we need to use here our text name, right? So here text 1, click on text box 1 and text box 1 dot text. We need to like this, that is right. So whenever you click on button, so Ellie will just hear sound is like hello, Harry, hello Ellie, like that, right? So now we are going to use here second screen, or right? So first we need to hide this one and visual arrangement 2. Okay. And now we are going to use here some browser for showing our GIF image, right? Because you know our image will not show GIF image, right, in our HTML render. So we are going to use here browser to show our image. So that one is okay. Here is my browser like this, and we are going to use here one button also. Okay, for getting input from user. So just use here, click here to ask like this, right? And change like 20. Default background color is orange, and with is transparent, right? And browser hide is transparent, and with is also transparent. Now we are going to set here image, right? So here so we need to upload here two images. For one is without GIF, or second one is GIF. Like that one is JPG, or that one is GIF, right? We need to upload both images, so just open that one and upload it, and it comes again. Okay, and we are going to use the second image also, so like this one, like this. So we need to set these images, so we have to write here some code. So that one is file colon slash. And here we are going to use code for, like, if we have the code, so we need to use Android asset and our image name, like our GIF image name is egif.gif, right? So egif.gif, like that, right? That one is our image here. So now we are going to block section and click on the button 2, and whenever someone click on button 2, so we are calling to speech recognition, right? So call speech recognition to getting the text from the user, right? And after getting text, we need to convert this text in speech, right? So after getting text like this, so suppose if I will get the text like what is the capital of US, right? Someone asked to me what is the capital of US. So we need to define here answer, right? So we are going to use here if else condition to check this. So control if, so call this function like this, and our text we need to use here logic to like that one, and use here text if text is equal to like what is the capital of US. If that one text is equal to our speech recognition text, so what should we have to do here to show the, so getting the text, right? So we need to use here get result. If get result equal to our text like this, right? So we are going to use here, we need to tell them that one is what is the condition, like what is the capital of US. So that one answer is like need to show them. So we need to use here speech recognition text to speech. So call text to speech that And answer is like the capital of US is Washington DC, like this, right? So here you can see that one is our text, right? So wait some seconds to clear this one, clear this thing, right? So now we are going to change the image also, right? So first we need to use here web browser. Whenever someone is, whenever we got the text, after getting text, our image will change like web URL here. Like, wait some seconds to get in this. Okay, so whenever we call web browser one, and here we will define our URL, right? Which is use here URL to whenever after getting text, our GIF image will show, right? Like we need to copy and paste this code here, and like or after completed the text, like after speech, after completed the speech, we need to before speaking, after speaking. Okay, after speaking, that one, right? So we need to use here speech recognition after getting the text, after getting text. Okay, before getting text, get text, that one, after speaking. So after speaking, we will call web browser to our simple GIF JPG image, right? ejpg.jpg, that one. So now you will see here, whenever we click on ask button, and when we some are whenever we ask like what is the capital of US, then that one will check. If user say what is the capital of US, then if condition is true, then call text to speech, then speak our LU, the capital of US is Washington DC. And else, if we will not get the correct question, then we need to use here else option. Then that one is like we will get, sorry, you can, sorry, pardon me. Right, that so that one is the app for, you can use like here if I'm using only one condition, you can like if else if, like you can use here many else if, like if that one is not a question, then we are going to use here like here this one, what is the capital of India, right? And getting result. So if that one text is equal to 2, our speech recorded after getting text, then our answer like the capital of India is New Delhi. The capital of India is New Delhi, right? So if you have any doubt, you can ask me. Okay, so you can create your own AI app with this help of this tutorial. And whenever you will get in doubt, you can ask me on comment, I'll give you proper answer, right? So thank you so much for watching this video. You can if you want to use this app, so you can download this app from Play Store. I'll give you this description link of this app in description, right? And you can use this app to click on build option, and here provide QR code for APK. You need to just click on QR code and just scan this QR code in your mobile while using MIT app campaign, right? You can download this app from Play Store. That one is the MIT app for getting the for the live testing. Also, you can use this app for live testing, right? And download this app and use this app. You can use this QR code for download this app, right? Or if you have any doubt, you can ask me on comment. And thank you so much for watching this video. Please like my video and subscribe my channel. Thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you.